Hi there, welcome to my core stability, strength and balance routine, which is the fourth day in my Commit to Fit Today program. It's a full hour of training. Obviously there's a lot of core work, it's primarily core work. We're always engaging the spine, we're always engaging the abdominals, the obliques, all of the core muscles. I do a lot of focus, other than strength, on stability and balance work as well, but engaging with the core in order to do that. Some might liken this to a calisthenics class with mixed with Pilates, mixed with yoga. It is entirely my own program. But I do try to mix the elements and I try to mix and match the way in which we do all of it. So it's a full hour, there's no blocking, there's no minute routines. We're just flowing from one position into the next, the next, the next. I hope you'll join me. It is, as I said, a full hour, so there's no breaking in between. Just keep going. If you need to take a break, take it on your own. Come straight back into it. Don't lose your posture, don't lose your control. Alright, so we're going to start off with a full hour. We're going to roll down, we're going to let your head drop, shoulders drop, upper, middle, lower, all the way down. Let your head hang, arms hang, spine hang. Relax the neck, relax the arms, relax the spine. Deep breathing, relax your feet. Soft knees, we're slowly going to roll up, in through your nose, out through your mouth. Shoulders back, nice long neck, arms up. Deep breathing, relax the feet. We're going to reach through the middle and upper back. Extend your neck, but don't hang your head. Keep the weight in the heel of the foot. And up, and we're going to drop down. We're going to go again. Head drop, shoulders up, middle over. Don't worry about whether or not you can touch the floor. Just relax completely. Let your knees bend a little bit. Soft knees, we're slowly going to roll up. Tuck your chin into your chest until your spine is straight. Completely relax the feet. Shoulders back, nice long neck. And we're going to reach back. Don't hold that breath. Good, we're going to do two more of these. Let the head drop, shoulders drop, upper, middle, lower. All the way down, relax the neck, relax the arms, relax the spine. Deep breathing in through your nose, out through your mouth. Don't hold your breath. Soft knees, we're slowly going to roll up. Into the nose, out through the mouth. Shoulders back, nice long neck. And we're going to reach back, relax those feet. Deep breathing. Good. Up and drop. Let your head drop. Shoulders drop. Upper, middle, lower. All the way down. In through the nose. Out through the mouth. Don't hold your breath. We're going to stay down. Now, depending on your level of flexibility, point number one is your thumbs are down at the very least. Keep that thumb down. You're going to extend and release as much as you can without lifting the thumb. Now, if you can't straighten your legs, don't worry about it. And you should focus on thumbs down first. Try and think of extending your spine second, and then extend the legs, alright? We're going to keep doing this. If you are more flexible, your palms are flat. If you're even more flexible than that, as you extend, I want you to drop your elbows, alright? Let's go. For 8 more. 7, relax your toes. 6, deep breathing. 5. 4. 3. Let's go. 2, 1, soft knees, we're going to roll up, 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 don't hold the breath, good, our arms are up, we reach back, in through your nose and out through your mouth, and we're going to go, side, side, this is a gentle movement, it's not going very far, we're not moving in the upper spine, and we're not moving in the hips, we're not dancing, we're moving from the lower spine, so isolate that movement to feel like it's coming from there, alright, which is exactly where all the core muscles are based. Let's go. 4, tummy tight, spine lengthened. 3, bum tight. 2, 1, we're going to roll down again, all the way down, this time the straight legs. When you're at your max, release your knees, let your spine melt. Soften your knees, you're going to roll back. On that way up, you're going to go to the ball of the foot. Reach your arms up to the ceiling. And we're going to release. We're going to roll down, straight legs. When you're at your max position, you're going to release the knees. At your head hang, arms hang, spine hang. Soft knees, we're going to roll up. Deep breathing in through your nose, out through your mouth. We're going to go to the ball of the foot. And we're going to drop. We're going to go again. 2 more. All the way down. Deep breathing through inhale, contact spine length, soft knees, we're going to roll up. One more to go. Up. Good. We're going to drop all the way down. Your head hang, contact spine hang. Completely release, relax the feet, palms flat. Everyone is now palms flat. You extend your knees as much as you can. What we don't want is that. I don't care how straight the legs are. I need you to focus on keeping the palms flat. Alright? For 8. 7. Deep breathing. 6. In through your nose, out through your mouth. 5. Keep it going. 4 more. 3 more. 2 more. Relax the toes. 1. Soft knees. We're going to roll up. Deep breathing. In through your nose, out through your mouth. Don't hold your breath. Arms up. We're going to go to ball of the foot. We're going to stay there. We're going to reach through the middle and upper back. Reach the arms back as much as you can. Stay on the ball of that foot. And we're going to release. We're going to go into a squat. We're going to start speeding things up just a little. Let's go for 10. Now while you're doing this, you're pushing your weight to the heel of the foot, pushing your bum back, keeping your chest lifted. Your bum drops lower than your shoulders. Let's go. 5, 4, 3, 2, and we're going to hold. Deep breathing. If you can sit lower, you sit lower. Otherwise, you gap. Reach your fingertips forward without transferring weight into them. Extend your legs, pull your body weight all the way back into the heels. Grab behind the ankles and you're going to pull in. Soft knees, we're going to roll back. In through your nose, out through your mouth. Let's go. We squat. We reach. We're extending, relaxing your toes. We're pulling back, we're grabbing behind the heels and we're pulling in. Deep breathing in through your nose, out through your mouth. Don't hold your breath. We're going to squat. Hold it. Reach forward. Extend as much as you can without transferring weight into your hands. We're going to grab behind the heels. We're going to pull in. We're going to roll up. Let's do 2 more, 3 more. Let's do 3 more. Squat. Reach. Extend as much as you can. We're going to pull in. We're going to grab behind. Don't let the head tuck. Let this movement come from the hip joint. Soft knees, we're slowly going to roll up. Don't hold the breath. 2 more. Sometimes I say 2 more and I mean 3. Sometimes I think 3 more and I mean 2. Extend, let's go. Grab behind and pull in. Extending your spine. Release, we're going to roll up. We're going to do 1 more. I mean that. Let's hold. Release, take your hands further forward. Extend, now we're not taking the hands back, we're going to leave them there. Release, take them a bit further forward, but make sure you're putting that body weight back because we're going to extend and release 8 more times. Let's go. 4, 8. And release. 7, deep breathing. And release. 6, don't hold the breath, relax the toes. 5. And release. 4. And release. 3. Good. 2 more. And release. And 1. And we're going to hold. Relax the feet. Grab behind the heels. Alright. And we pull. Release. Pull. Extending the spine with the movement come from the hip joint. Pull. Release. Let's do 8 more. 8. Don't tuck the head in. So we're not doing that. 7. Extend your spine. 6. In the movement, come from the hip. Keep going. 5. In through the nose, out through the mouth. 4. 3. Good. 2. Relax the toes. 1 more to go. 1. Good. Now, we're going to walk forward into a plank position. Alright. So your hands directly under your shoulders. This is where our core work starts. Pushing the heels back, locking the knees. We're going to push off the hands into the feet as far as you can, flat back and straight legs, even if it's just to there. You try ideally to get your arms and spine in the same line, back down to here. Focus, extend your spine, tuck your butt, lengthen your neck. lunge up off your hands into your feet. And back to plank. Let's do this again. Eight more. Eight. Push off your hands into your feet. And forward. Back to plank. Seven. Deep breathing. In through your nose, out through your mouth. And release. Let's go. Six. Two. And back. Keep going. Five. Back. Flat back. Flat back. Flat back. Four. Push your weight off your hands into your feet. Back. Good. We've got three to go. Three. Two. And back. Don't hold your breath. Two more. Two. Back. One more. One. Two. And back. Now, we're going to drop. We're going to point our feet. We're going to lock our knees. Shoulders back into your nose, out through your mouth. We're going to just want to do what is called a cobra in yoga. Locking your knees, but you're not going all the way up. Keeping the knees locked, elbows in, shoulders back, hands directly under your armpits. We lift as much as you can without bending the knees, and I don't want you to straighten the arms. So you're almost lifting completely. Up, let's go. Eight. And drop. Deep breathing, seven, extend your spine, extend your neck, and drop. You don't need to lock the elbows, we're not going to go that high up. Six. Drop, make sure that those knees are locked though. Point the feet, five. If your knees are locked and your feet are pointed, four, you shouldn't be able to extend your arms in this position. Let's go. Three more, hands under your chest, good, elbows in, two more, and we've got one more to go, good, and release. Now, we're going to tuck our toes, alright? We're going to take one leg up, as high as you can get it. We're going to come back into our plank position. We're going to swap. Other leg up, as high as you can get it. Back into plank position. Extending your spine. And up. And back to plank. Let's go. Deep breathing. Up, up. We're swapping legs. Back to plank. We're going to do eight more. Let's go. Eight. In through your nose, out through your mouth. Back to plank. Deep breathing. Seven. And drop. Six. Back to plank. Let's go. Five. And drop. Tummy's nice and tight, spine nice and extended. Four. Look forward, don't look under. Look at your hands. And drop. Keeping the spine extended, keep looking at the hands. Three. And drop. Two more. Keep looking at your hands. And drop. One more to go. And one. And drop. Good. You're going to bring your right leg forward. Okay. Locking the back knee into your hip. Drop. Hip and knees same height. From there, we're going to extend. Your hands are in line with your ankle. Don't let them walk back. Try not to tuck your head in. Think of extending your neck. And looking forward, not down. We're going to release. Lock the knee. We're going to rotate in the spine and look up. Then from there, hands down, we're going to lift up. Good, we're going to repeat that 9 times. We're going to extend, deep breathing, try and think of extending the spine. We're going to release. We're going to rotate. Push the back heel backwards. And drop. And up. Let's go. 8 more. Extend, deep breathing, don't hold your breath. Good, we're going to drop. We're going to rotate in through your nose, out through your mouth. And drop. And up. Don't hold your breath. And drop. Let's go. 7. I think. And drop. Locking that back knee. We rotate. Don't hold your breath. And drop. And up. Let's go. 6 more. Extend. Drop. Lock the back knee. The back knee stays locked. Right. We drop. Keep the back knee locked. Let the hip drop lower than the front knee. Drop. 5 more to go. Extend. Good. Drop. We rotate. Let's go. Up. 4 more to go. Extend. Drop. Let's go. Rotate. Drop. And up. Nearly forgot what we were doing then. Let's drop. 3 more to go. Extend. And drop. Rotate. Down. Up. We're going to do 2 more. Extend. Drop. Lock that back knee. Rotate. Down. Up, up. 1 more to go. Extend. Good. We drop. Keep that back knee locked. Hip lower than the front knee. And drop. Up. Good. Both hands to the inside of that front foot. In a swap. Push the bum up. We drop. 1 hand on either side of that front foot. Good. We're going to extend as much as you can. We're going to drop. Lock the back knee. We're going to rotate. Both hands down. Up, up. Good. 9 more. Extend. And drop. Lock the back knee. Let's go. Rotate. Drop. Good. Up. 2. 8 more. Up. Deep breathing. Drop. Rotate. Drop. Let's go. Up. Drop. I think we're at 7. 7. 2. Up. Rotate. Drop. Let's go. Up. Good. Drop. 6. 2. Drop. Up. And down. Relax the foot. Let's go. four, and drop. We rotate, and down, and up. Good. Three more. Don't hold that breath. Extend the upper spine, and drop. And we rotate. And down. And up. Two more. Extend. Drop. Relax your feet. Rotate. Drop. Up. One more to go. Extend. Two. Drop. Rotate. Drop. And up. Both hands to the inside. We push that leg back. We drop the heels down. So we're going to go all the way down. Drop the knees. Push the bum back. Sitting on your feet. We're going to come up to here. Now we're going to do two to three positions. We're going to reach back. Seated, first one. We're going to drop. We're going to come up. We're going to lean back. Actually lean back. Arms out to the side. Shoulder, hip, knee. Same line. Up. We're going to go into a narrow dog stretch, hand directly underneath the shoulder. Push up. And drop. Sit on your feet. We reach back. Good. Up, arms up. We lean back. Extending the spine, long neck. Up. We drop. Hands on the shoulders. Deep breathing, push all that weight backwards. And we drop, we've got eight more. Seated up, reach the arms back. Good, arms up to the side. We lean back, in through the nose, out through the mouth, nice straight line. Up, hands down, under the shoulders. Up, up. Let's go. Seven more, up. We seated. And up. We're leaning back. Nice long neck, shoulder, hip, knee, same line. Up, we're not rushing. There's no rush. Push up. Don't hold the breath. And drop. Six more, up. Don't hold that breath. Each time you go into the stretch or into the position, try and go deeper and deeper into it. Make it harder and harder. And up. Let's go. Keep going. Four more. Up, reach back. Good. Up, we're going to lean further back. Deep breathing, don't hold your breath. And up, you're going to feel that in the quads. Up. Let's go. And drop. Three more. Up. Deep breathing. Don't hold your breath. Good. Up, nice, lean back, in through your nose, out through your mouth. Good. We're going to drop, tuck the toes, push up. We're going to release. We're going to sit. I think this is two more, one more. Let's add one more for good measure because I always forget my count. And it's not a bad thing to do an extra. Right, let's lean. Up. And up. Let's go. Good. Last one, even though we might have had the last one already, it doesn't matter. Extra's always good. Up. Bum tucked. We lean. Lean, let's hold. Let's hold. For four, stay there. Three, tummy tight. Two. And one, good. Hands down, we're going to push up. Now I want us to walk back, bend your knees enough to get your palms flat. Extend and release. Stay extend and release. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, keep going, 3, 2, and you're going to hold. Stay there, stay there. Let your head hang, let your arms hang, let your spine hang. We're going to completely and utterly flop. Alright, we're going to roll up. In through your nose, out through your mouth, you're going to hold your breath. Good. We're going to reach back. Good, now we're going to add some balance movement. We've got quite a bit of leg already. We're going to come to the middle of your mat. What we're going to do, very simple, very easy. Take your right leg up, left hand behind your back. You're just going to touch the floor. And when you touch, your standing knee is going to bend a little bit, enough to go down. Flatten back and up. That's all we're doing. We're going to do 3 sets of this, and each set is going to get harder and harder. Let's go. 10 and up. 9. I'm not terribly fussed about the back leg. I think bend it like I'm doing. 8. I'm more fussed about working your standing leg for now. 7. Keep it going. Deep breathing. In through your nose, out through your mouth. 6, you'll definitely feel this on the bum, on the glutes and the hamstrings. Let's go. 5. Opposite hand is behind your back. 4 more. Don't hold your breath. Let's go. 3 more. Deep breathing. 2 more. 1 more to go. Let's go. Good. We're going to do the other side. So, right hand behind the back, left leg lifted, left hand is touching. We're going to drop and up. We're going to drop and up. So we're keeping the lifting leg at an easy pace, easy movement. 8, not worried about what it's doing just yet. 7, I want you to get familiar with the movement. So soften your standing knee. 6, that knee needs to bend a little bit. 5, don't hold your breath, you'll definitely feel this in the glutes. 4, keep it going. 3, let's go. 2, and up, one more to go, one more to go. Ooh, lost my balance there. And up, good. Now, we're going to go back to the first leg. So your right leg is back, but now I want the knee to lock, alright? Left hand behind the back, right hand's touching. So we're going to try and lock that leg, touch the floor. Don't worry too much about the upper body just yet, but keep that knee locked. That's your most important part. Your standing knee is bending, your lifting leg is straight. Now, if you are more flexible, I want you to keep that leg in line with the spine. And your idea is that I'd rather you bend your standing leg and let that work more. Let's do 7. Keep this knee locked. What we don't want is this. Okay, now try and lift that leg with the spine going. Leg goes up, spine goes down. Up 5 more. And 5. Don't hold your breath. 4 more. 4. And let's go. 3 more. Good. And up. 2 more. And up. 1 more to go. And up. Good. Now, we're going to do the other side. So, your left leg is back, straight leg. Standing leg, knees bent, shoulders back. Ideally, keep your spine and leg in the same line. Most importantly, straighten the lifting leg. We're going to drop. And up. Make sure that that thumb touches the floor. Let's go. We drop and up. In through your nose, out through your mouth. Keep that lifting leg straight. 7. No, now that was 8. Let's go. 7. Don't hold your breath. Keep going. 6. And up. 5. You'll feel this pinch in the lower back. It's probably because it's working. 4. Feels too uncomfortable, you can sit it out. got three more. And up. And this is where you really can start being testing the balance. Two. But you are feeling a good workout in the glutes. And one, you need to engage that core to keep your balance. You want to think of extending the spine tummy tight. Now, the third rep routine. Alright? Keep that leg back. Alrighty? Same hand on the leg that's lifting is the one that's touching the floor. The other hand is behind the ear. And what we're going to do from there is we're going to touch. And as you come up, you're going to bring that knee to the elbow. Release, straight leg. We're going to reach for the floor. If you can't touch the floor, don't stress. Try to at least get your spine and leg parallel to the floor. In. And we're going to go. We're going to reach. And up. Soften that standing leg. Good, that was eight. Let's go. Seven. Try and keep that leg in line with the spine. And up when it's going up. Let's go. Six. Deep breathing. This is very hard, I know. And up. And five. And up. Four. Ideally, we try not to put that leg down. Try not to let it touch the floor. Three more to go. And up. Two more. Now your standing foot might start cramping at the ankle. But we've got one more to go and then we're done with the side. Last one. Try not to touch the floor. Get through the last one. And up. And release. Good. Now, that standing ankle, you can flop it if it's sore. Otherwise, we're going to go to the other side. So, left leg is back, straight leg. Right hand is behind the ears. Left hand is touching spine and leg, ideally on a straight line. At the very least, your lifting leg is straight. And we're going to drop. Up. Bring the elbow to the knee. Nice and slow, there's no rush. And we drop. And we're going to come up. Touch that knee. Try not to touch the floor like we just had. Let's go. Eight more. Up. And back. Seven. If you're losing your balance, try and focus on a non-moving object. Let's go. Six. And back. Five. I'm looking at a non-moving spot. Let's go. Four. Keep going. And back. Three. And back. Back. One more to go. And back. And we're going to release. We're going to relax the back. The head hand on the spine head. Soft knees. Good. Right, from there, I'm going to let the legs relax a little bit. Arm tucked, spine leg, shoulders back, arms up. And when your arms are up, it's not here. Extend with the bum tucked. We're going to go side to side. In this movement, we'll do two versions. And basically just two different speeds. So cinch, that movement is coming from the lower spine. Alright? We're not collapsing here. We're not moving the shoulders. Think of your last rib to the tips of your fingers being one straight, unbroken line. And that movement is coming from the lower spine. Now with the speed, start getting comfortable with it. And the further you can go sideways, the better. But at the speed, let's go. Eight. You want to make it easier. Seven. I always interlink fingers. Six. 5, 4, 3. Now we're trying not to move the lower spine to or from the upper spine. 1. Now we're going to move the upper body quicker. Let's go. 8. I just made a mistake with what I said. 7. You're trying not to move the lower body. 6. And you're trying not to let the movement come from the upper spine. All that movement, all the bending, comes from the lower spine. Let's go for 8 more. Keep the arms back. 7. Keep that tummy tight. 6. Let's go. 5. Deep breathing. Don't hold your breath. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Good. Now, from here, soft knees. We've really worked our back quite a lot, so you go as far as you feel comfortable. But we're not squatting. We're going to reach forward and back. And all we're doing is getting yourself kind of a tabletop position with your spine. Reach forward and you're trying to get your hands higher than the shoulders. Let's reach and relax the toes. For 8. And up. 7. Now as you come up, I want you to really think of squeezing the bum cheeks up. 6. And up. Squeeze those bum cheeks in. 5. Deep breathing. And up. 4 more to go. And up. Let's go. 3. Don't hold the breath. 2. And up. 1 more. Hold. Relax the toes. And we're going to release. Good. Now, your knees are only slightly bent. We're going to come up into a flat back again. We're only going to go halfway up this time. And we release. And the intention is to really think of extending that spine. Keeping your knees only slightly bent. Let's do 10 more. And drop. Relax the toes. 9. Deep breathing. Get the hands higher than the shoulders when you're at the top. 8. Hands higher than the shoulders. Up, 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 up. And drop. Let's go. 7. And drop. Deep breathing. 6. In through your nose, out through your mouth. And drop. 5. Let's go. 4 more. And drop. 3 more. And drop. 2 more. And drop. 1 more. And release. Good. Now we're going to go back down to our knees. Alright. Again, you want to do your best to really extend the spine. You want to put your tummy in tight, shoulders back, hands directly underneath the shoulders, knees directly underneath the hips. We've done this before, but what we're going to do is we're going to add to it now. So giving the back a good break, we're going to give the legs a bit of a stretch. We're going to push up into a narrow dog stretch like we've done before. If you can't get your legs straight, doesn't matter. I'd rather you focus on getting the back flatter before you straighten the legs. We're going to come down and we're going to hover. So we're not going to release completely. Spine stays extended. Let's go for 10. And back to a hover. Let's go. 9. Up, up. Back to a hover. Keep going. And 8. Deep breathing. Don't hold your breath. Back to a hover. Let's go. 7. And drop. 6. So when we come into the hover, we're going to basically be an inch above the floor. And drop. 5. And drop. 4. And drop. 3. Don't hold your breath. And drop. 2. And drop. Nice. nice and slow. There's never a need to rush it in. One more. Now here's where the work's gonna come. And drop. You're gonna hold your knees about an inch from the floor, maybe three. Parallel. So your shins are parallel to the floor. Let's go with that. And a one to small pulse. In through the nose, out through the mouth. Extend the spine, tummy's tight. 10. 9. 8. 7. Flat back. 6. 5. Deep breathing. 4. 3. 2. We're going to try another round. 1. If you need a break, take it quickly. Let's go. And 10. If those thighs to fire. 9. 8. Deep breathing. 7. In through your nose. 6. Don't hold your breath. 5. 4 more. 3. 2. And 1. Good. Let's give the arms and the thighs a bit of a break. We're going to go to the abdominals. Stretch the arms forward. Deep breathing. Don't hold your breath. Good. Let's go straight to the bum. Okay. Shoulders back. In through your nose, out through your mouth. I've got one breath. Sweet. Woo. Okay. So, what I want, ball of the foot and heels down. Don't let your feet collapse open. Don't let the ball of the foot lift. And I want you to make sure you're pushing your ankles toward each other, not away from each other. So really plant that foot down. We're going to lean back. And then just think of extending the spine. We're going to raise the right arm. We're going to hold on with the left hand, not the left knee. We're not slouching. We're lifting. And you're going to lift that foot as high as the hand. So this hand is as high as that shoulder. I need you to lift that foot as high as the hand or higher. All right? Try your best. What we don't want is that leg to drop. We want the knee to stay the same height as the other knee. So basically it's there. Alright? Let's go. 10. Good. Shoulders back. 9. If you want to get a bit of a stretch, you're going to flex that foot. 8. Let's go. 7. Don't hold your breath. 6. Nice long neck. 5. Deep breathing. 4. Try and get that foot higher than the shoulder. 3. Get this parallel. 2. And 1. Good. Swap sides. Shoulders back. 90 at the knees. Other arm up. Let's go. We're going to extend. Extend. Let's do 10 more with a flexed foot. 10, 9, nice long neck, 8, if you're feeling strong, 7, keep the spine extended, 6, keep both hands the same height, 5, we're not going to repeat this, 4, but I'm going to do a much harder version, so you're more than welcome to stay there, 3, keep that hand down, 2, and 1, good, now, we're going to give the hip flexors a bit of a break. We're going to drop down from here, our knees and our feet, shoulder width apart, our 90 degrees to the knees. We're going to lift, drop, nice and easy. Lift, drop, let's go. 10, drop, nice and easy. 9, remember there's always going to be a harder version. So if you're feeling it's getting too easy, 8, it's because I'm preparing you for a harder version. 7. Let's go. 6. Drop. 5. Drop. Let's go. 4. Drop. 3. Keep going with me. 2. Drop. Last one, we're going to stay up. Pulse. Pulse. 10. This isn't the harder version yet. 9, this is still the rest of the first version, 8, 7, 6, 5, deep breathing. 4, ribcage is tight. 3, keep going. 2, 1, good. Now we're going to come back up into that seated position. I'm going to do a harder version now. So, 9, take the knees. Ball of the foot is down. One hand is holding on. I'm going to show you basically just there. From now, we're going to extend, we're going to drop, we're going to lift and bend. Alright? Other arm is there. Okay, if it's too hard for you, you're going to grab both hands on the opposite knee. Otherwise, you're there. Or hardest version, both hands lifted. So we're going to start off with the easiest version. Shoulders back. We're going to lift our leg, but we're not going to drop it yet. We're going to lift up first. We're going to drop. We're going to lift. We're going to bend. I'm going to show you second hardest version. We're going to lift. We're going to drop. We're going to lift. We're going to bend. Hardest version. Extend. Nice extended spine. Up. And then 8 more. If you want to get a bit of a stretch, flex that foot. We're going to go nice extended spine. 7. Let's drop. Up. And then 6. If you want to make it super hard, take your hands behind the ears. As long as the spine is extended, 5. As long as you are getting that leg height, 4. It's there. Let's go. 3. Otherwise, you're here. 2. Without slouching. And up. One more to go. 1. Super hard exercise. Up. And release. Good. Your quad and your hip flexor should be firing like mad by now. Okay, so easy version. Other leg. Extend. Drop, up, and release. Medium version, up, 2, up, release. Hard version, up, 2, up, extend the spine. Super hard version, extend, but with an extended spine, up, and release. 6, let's go, up, and release. 5, flex the foot for a deeper stretch, up, and release. 4, keep going, otherwise you're here, release with an extended spine. 3, don't forget to extend that spine, lift the chest. 2, don't rush the exercise. Up, 1 more. Good, and release. Good, we're going to give those hips a bit of a break. Quads, hip flexors, a bit of a break. We're going to go back to the bum. Here comes the harder version of what we were doing. Right, knees and feet shoulder width apart. We're going to lift, we're going to squeeze, open, and drop. I'm just moving a bit more to the mat. Lift, squeeze, open, and drop. This is a very nice exercise. It's not meant to feel horrible, but it is a good workout. Let's go 8, squeeze. The work part hasn't started yet. 7, this is the preparatory part. Let's go. Now, if your knees are touching when you get there, your feet are too close together, you need to make it harder. 6, by opening the feet wide enough so that you really struggle to get the knees to touch. 4 more. Let's go. 3 more. Keep going. 2 more. And then 1 more to go. Now we're going to stay up. We squeeze. Open nice and slow. Now again, if your knees are touching, the exercise is going to be too easy. You need to be really struggling to get those knees to touch. So open your feet wide enough. 8. Let's go. 7. Get those hips up. Tummy tight. 6. Wide. The ball of the foot stays down. 5. 1. Let's go. 4. Keep going. Your feet are parallel. 3, up, 2, open, 1. Now you're going to hold those legs as wide as you can. Turn the ball of the foot out to get the knees a little wider and pulse. Now, tuck your coccyx in and pulse. 2, 3, 4, 9. We're doing 14 in total. Toes turned out. 8, knees nice and wide, but make sure the ball of the foot is down. Let's go. 7, keep going. Don't hold that breath. 6, 5, go. Keep going. Three. Keep going. Two. And one. Good. Bring those knees in. Give your bum a bit of a break now. Now we're going to work upper body. Extend. You're going to drop to about 45 degrees, all right? You want to make sure that you're pushing that lower back down. Think of putting your belly button into your back as opposed to pushing it up. You want to pull that tummy tight. You're going to keep it there. Shoulder blades lifted. Chin away from the chest. You're going to extend as much as you can. You're going to drop straight leg. Just about 45 degrees. You're going to come back up and bend. Now raise your head in your hands. 10. 2. Up. Release. 9. 2. Deep breathing. Up. Now while you're doing this, I really need you to focus. Hey, so thinking about putting that belly button down, especially when your legs are going out. That's when you're putting your belly button in the hardest. 7. And drop. Up. Release. 6. 2. Up. Release. We're going to make the super hardest now. 5. 2. Up. Release. 4. 2. Up. Release. 3. 2. Up. Release. 1. 2. Up. Now we're going to release. Crunch. This movement, simple, basic, easy crunch. But you've got to focus as much as possible not to move in the neck when we're doing it. You want to think of lifting the upper back and the shoulder blades off the floor. Maybe even the middle back. Think of pulling your belly button in tight, pushing that lower back into the floor. You're almost tilting your coccyx up and taking the pressure off your bum off the floor. So it's not actually resting. 7. Let's go. 6. Deep breathing. 5. Keep going. 4 more. Let's go. 3 more. Deep breathing. 2 more. And 1. Now we're going to hold it. So now the abdominals have been working quite hard. Chin away from the chest. Shoulder blades stay lifted. Belly button stays down. We're going to come back to that leg exercise, except we're going to add to it. We're going to extend. We're going to drop halfway. One leg goes all the way. Back up to half. Back up to top. Bend. Simple, right? Lift the chest. And extend. Halfway. Wait. Other leg drops full way. All the way up. Up, up. Bend. Let's go. 10. Half. One leg full. Other leg. Back up. In. And drop. Up, up. 9. Half. Other leg full. Back up. All the way up. And drop. 8 more. 8. Tummy tight. Halfway. Drop full leg. Half up. Back up. And in. 7. Half. Second leg. Back up to half. All the way up. And in. Let's go. 6. Shoulder blades lifted. Chin away from the chest. You're looking up at the ceiling, not at your crotch. First leg, full way. Back to half. Up and release. Let's go. Up. Halfway. Second leg. Full way. Back up to half. All the way up. And release. 4 more. Let's go. Half. Full. Half. All the way up. Release. 3 more. Shoulder blades lifted. Upper body. Half. Full. Half. All the way up. Release. Last 2 to go. 1 up. Half. Full. Half. All the way up. Release. Last 1. Up, up. Half. Full. Half. All the way up. And release. Good. Now, simple exercise. Releasing of the lower back. both knees up, arms out to the side. We're going to drop and up, deep breathing, and drop and up, shoulder blades are down, 8, up, 7, deep breathing, up, 6, up, 5, up, 4, keep going, 3, up, 2, up, 1 more, 1, good, and release. We're going to sit up, we're going to stretch, good. Unfortunately my timer's a bit off, didn't charge it, shoulders back, and we're going to release. So I'm either giving you too much time or too little time, but I don't want to check and break the video. And up, but walk all the way forward, all the way down, and hold it. We're going to pull back, round the back, tuck your chin into your chest. Sit up. We're going to try and bring those elbows in front of the shin again. Remember, we're not collapsing. Extend the spine. Pull in. Pull in. Try and pull those elbows in front. Don't hold your breath. In through your nose, out through your mouth. And release. And pull back. All the way back. Don't hold the breath. One more to go. Extend. Bring the elbows in front of the shins. All the way down, and release, all the way back, lean to one side, so you're pulling backwards, you're rounding your back, scooping out your spine, tucking your chin into your chest, lean your head to your left shoulder, and then lean the whole upper body toward that left shoulder, up to the left leg, good, release, lean your head to the right shoulder, the whole upper body to the right side, and release. Let's go again. Keep pulling your weight backwards, lean to one side, as much as you can, and release. Full body, lean to the other side, and release, and you're going to come back down, bringing those elbows just in front. Good. We're going to come up, we're going to go back into a nice dog stretch, narrow one, we're going to push up, all the way up, you're going to come down, walk your hands forward to the direct end of the shoulders, let your hips release, knees down, push the bum back, you're going to come all the way forward, drop that hip, okay, you've got two options, you're either just going to push your ankle down, lifting that back knee over the floor and letting your hips sink, alright, or you're going to grab the back foot and you're going to push the hip forward. Don't hold your breath, extend your spine as much as you can. Deep breathing. We're going to release, we're going to pull back. To lift the back knee, right, everyone lift the back knee, pointed back foot, let the hip hang, if you are more flexible and you can grab the back foot, drop the back knee, grab the foot, let the hip sink. And we release, we're going to push up into the dog stretch. You're going to bring the other leg forward, you're going to point the foot, again, you're going to lift the back knee, drop the back ankle, if you are more flexible, you're going to grab the back foot, and you're going to hold that, stay there. That is finally my hour, don't move, I wasn't bad. Next time I promise to charge.
punch my watch.
Hold that. Hold it there. Deep breathing. And we're going to release and we're going to pull back. Don't hold your breath. Flex that foot. I'm sorry for the technical difficulties. I've actually had to record this video twice because my camera stopped and then my watch stopped. So, and forward, drop, lift the back knee, everyone, point the back foot, let the hips sink. And we're going to release, and we're going to grab that back foot and push the hip forward. All the way forward. And we release. And we push back, push the bum up, drop the heels, deep breathing in through your nose, out through your mouth. And we walk back, and we flop, let the head hang, let the arms hang, let the spine hang, doesn't matter what your flexibility is, I want you to straighten your legs, so even if you're there, just let everything hang. Then bend your knees enough to get your spine to completely relax in an extended position, and you're going to soften your knees and you're going to roll up. In through your nose, out through your mouth, don't hold your breath. Shoulders back. We're going to reach up, we're going to reach back. And we're going to release. Thank you for joining me. Sorry for the technical glitch, but it's still a really good workout. I really enjoyed doing that today. I hope you enjoyed doing it too. I'll see you soon. Please join me tomorrow for the Super Circuit Power Training. Set soon.